Weiter auch HW95 Luxus Test bei Air Gandhi. Servus, thanks for dropping in. Today I have something special for the brake barrel friends among you. I present you the Weihrauch HW95 Luxus. I will tell you a lot about the special features. We do the crony test, a trigger test, and of course a shooting test. The Weihrauch HW95 is a sister model to the Weihrauch HW98. I already reviewed this rifle, that's especially suitable for field target. Anyone who missed the video can simply visit airgandhi.de/en and enter HW98 in the search bar, or of course enter HW98 on YouTube. I think my video will also appear there in the English-speaking area, so you can catch up with it. Okay, what does the HW95 bring to the table? I'd say we'll look at the close-ups first. Here in front we have the rear side tunnel with the internal rear side blade. The rear side blade can be removed. The scope of delivery includes four more that have different shapes, so you can simply decide which rear side you want to have inserted the moment you want to shoot with open sight. Then we have the 41 cm long rifled barrel. Here we've got the rear side, adjustable in height and sideways. The special thing about the rear side is that it can be rotated, and then you also have the option of choosing from four different rear side cutouts. Next is the system. On the system is an 11 mm prism rail. It has, typical for Weihrauch, three holes. One here, and one here. If you have a mount with a stopper pin, which I would always recommend with a spring piston, so that the scope does not move, you have the option of inserting the stopper pin into the hole here, and then it is protected from slipping. Here in the forearm area you can see a quite rough punching. This makes it possible for you to hold the rifle even with sweaty, slippery hands without slipping. You can also see the chasing here in the grip area. Then we have a double-sided cheekpiece and a rubberized butt plate. Overall, the rifle is 107.5 cm long and weighs 3.4 kg. With this size, it ranks between the small rifles like a HW30 and a quite large and heavier guns like HW35, which weighs 3.8 kg. That means it is a bit more handy and compact, but we'll see how it handles the shooting test later. Now we first do the trigger test and see how the match trigger record, which is installed in all high quality Weihrauch guns, is set straight from the factory. To do this, I'll take my trigger tester and grab my safety glasses, which I forgot. Just a second. Okay, we take the trigger tester, set it to kilograms and grams, and take Air Gandhi's finest. These are the ones I use for the crony test and also for the shooting test. They work perfectly in the Weihrauch rifles. I don't use anything else there. The rifle, I'm just turning it upside down for a moment, is still secured. You can see here the automatic safety that activates the moment I cock the rifle. So yeah, you can't accidentally fire a shot. Don't be surprised, there's a shooting range in there for those who don't know it yet, which means I will simply shoot into this room. Deactivate the safety again. And then we see a trigger weight of 590 grams. Trigger is set up beautifully. It has a clear pressure point, and directly after the pressure point, you trigger the shot with a weight of 590 grams. Now I'd say we do the crony test and then the shooting test. Have fun. So here we are at the crony test. Air Gandhi's finest, 0.56 gram, and we're going to take 10 shots and look at the performance and consistency. Okay, we've taken 10 shots. You've already seen it's quite powerful. Number of shots 10, average 8.4 joules. I'll say something about that in a moment. 173 meters on average, 171 to 175, a deviation of 4 meters. That's an amazing result. And standard deviation from the average 1 meter per second. Just one more thing about the performance. Don't worry, as long as you haven't tampered with the rifle. The rifle is approved, which means that if you don't tamper with the springs or anything else, it's perfectly legal and the performance, it's a factory fresh rifle, will still settle a bit. That is, if you make a few hundred rounds, then it will be a little less. Therefore, you do not need to be afraid when you buy one, as long as you don't manipulate the rifle. Now, let's go directly to the shooting test. So, we are at the shooting test now. I'll give you some information about my setup. As a scope, I have an atypical one. It is actually more of a hunting scope, the Hawk Frontier 3-15x50 FFP. This is actually a glass for hunting, but I wanted to test everything that's available, and that's why I got this one installed on a rifle. A Sportsmatch UK mount, of course, TO36C. You can, of course, find it in my store on www.jabolo.de. I'm shooting Airgunny's finest, of course, like I just said in a chromium test. It looks a little different today. In fact, I have a different base today. I want to explain this very briefly. If you saw my HW98 video, you saw that I struggled to get a decent result with it. The HW95 is the sister model, and I can't say exactly what the problem is, but I have a hard time with these two rifles. They are the only two that I have any trouble with, but I have seen several times that they are highly accurate. For one thing, when Marco Greetings was here the last time and took the HW98, he simply shot the whole time into a single hole. I didn't get it together, and that's a competition rifle. I've seen them at many competitions, so they're precise. I now have to shoot them differently than I usually do. You may know my videos where I explain the holding technique, the artillery hold, which I normally use when shooting spring pistons. That means that I lay the rifle on my hand. But that doesn't work for me with the HW95, and that's why I've now tried to get used to this a little bit. So quite smooth pads in the front and the back, and I hold the pad in the back, and I don't put my hand under the rifle in front. I know that many people always shoot their spring pistons like this or shoot their competitions like this. For me, it's quite unusual, so I'm sorry if the result may be not perfect. Yeah, and for the loyal spectators who have wondered why I shoot differently today, I simply wanted to give you an explanation. So HW95 Luxus. You see right here now, first of all, we have a wedge lock, which then holds the barrel that I have bent back in the system. I've already said that the safety is an automatic safety, which means that it went in automatically at the moment I cocked the rifle. And you can deactivate it here with your thumb. Now I'll concentrate for a moment and then we'll see what I can achieve here. Breaking the barrel, you see it works perfectly scratch-free and wonderful even without having to give a slap on it. Closing also without any scratching noises, just like a typical Weihrauch, flawless. When shooting break barrels, it is always good to hold the barrel, just get used to it. The handling of the rifle, you see it is just great. 3.4 kilograms weight, I mentioned it earlier. Now I have a relatively heavy glass on it, but you can really shoot with it for a long time. No problem at all. The difficult thing about shooting a spring piston is that a lot of them are quite, well, I'd say posture sensitive. That means you really have to get used to one way of shooting. You have to adjust the rifle to it because it makes a huge difference. If I were to lay the rifle on my hand, the spread or hit pattern would be completely different. That's why you really have to steer in your rifle the way you want to hold it afterwards. It even makes a difference how tightly you hold the rifle, for example. As you can see, I've gotten a little more comfortable with it. The first one took off a bit, but you know my motto. There is no covering up or anything. If I miss, it just stays there. I could maybe say something about the recoil. I would still classify it light to medium. The recoil is not particularly hard, even so the rifle is pretty powerful. The SQ10 is specified for 7.5 joule, but it also doesn't complain if you shoot with 8 or 9 joule at it. It's just about the wear of the polycarbonate discs, which of course do not last quite as long if the rifle has more power, but nothing will break. You can see now that was the eighth shot. They move in a really small circle, if you could delete the first one. Oof. As soon as I say it, I'm blowing the next one. I think I held the grip a little too tight. Try to hit the next one again. Now, what did I do now? I think that's what you get for thinking about too much about it. Yeah. at 10 shots, it automatically switches the target. I was wondering, but I still have it set up that way. Well, the 11th shot went on the new target, so I'd say we do a few more. Let's make sure we get a lot of hits now, not two less good ones like with the last 10 shots. As you can see, the handling of the rifle, lifting it, moving it, also the fact that it is so short and easy to handle, it is really nice. When I'm concentrating, it works. Okay, we'll do another one, I'd say. Yeah, you have to practice with these rifles. That's the way it is with break barrel shooting. When you buy a new one, you don't just fire 10 shots and all 10 hit the bullseye. You just have to adjust to the rifle as well. Here, but the stock, beautiful dark grip. It's beech wood, but it's walnut stained dark, so it really looks like a walnut stock. Really like that. Now let's head over to the result. Okay, this is the result for the Weidach HW95 Luxus. I think I really didn't do too bad, didn't I? I was looking for some excuses for myself at the beginning, and I had already prepared something where it might not turn out so well. But apart from a few rough misses, I mean, that's the way it is when break barrel shooting. I think it happens to everyone, apart from the absolute pros. But there's always one who just goes left or right. Otherwise, the hits were very, very close together. I'm really satisfied. But you could see, I just have to practice the new shooting technique a little bit, and you have to adjust to your rifle and get to grips with it. It's just not like with a PCP rifle, where you just hold it and the rifle somehow always shoots right at the spot. Shooting a spring piston has a little more character. There's more character in it than in a PCP. Like I said, I like both a lot, but they are just very different. Yeah, HW95 Luxus. Luxus, the name just says it all. The stock is beautiful. I absolutely love the dark stain. The rifle has grip. Technically, everything is flawless. Breaking, there's no scratching. There's a really nice pressure behind it. Yeah. As I said, the power will settle a bit over time. I explained that before. I'm sure otherwise the question would come up in the comments. For me, the rifle is for someone who does not want a HW35 or HW80, so none of the heavier models. Instead, simply a little smaller, but still the usual Weidach quality. The HW95 is absolutely the right choice. I think that's where it is placed bet. Suitable for the whole family, because it is not too heavy and nice and handy for using at a smaller shooting range. If you have a compact and nice to handle 1.20 meter rifle, there is enough space for lots of barrel breaking and so on. Yeah. From my side, that's an absolute positive recommendation. I had a ton of fun. I will keep on training. I will try again and again to use this, to me, new shooting technique. Many people have asked why I don't shoot differently, but once you get used to one technique, you just do it for years, yeah, you stick with it. HW95 Luxus has been a lot of fun for me. I hope you also had fun. Thank you very much for watching, and I'm quite sure that the next video will be here shortly. See you. Ciao, Servus, says Air Gandhi.